Hue and Saturation, a puzzle no longer, because we're about to show you how they work in Final Cut Pro.
First, select a clip and position the playhead over the clip so that we see it in the viewer. Then, navigate to the Enhancements icon under the viewer and choose Show Color Inspector, or use the shortcut Command 6. Navigate to this pop-up menu on the top and choose Hue and Saturation Curves. And these graphs will appear in the inspector. To adjust the view, we can choose View at the top and choose All Curves or Single Curves, which displays one curve at a time. We can click a button at the top of the color inspector to display a specific curve out of the six. We'll set it back to All Curves.
Brace yourself, because we have a lot to go over.
So the reason it's called Hue and Saturation Curves is that we have these three graphs at the top for changing one hue to another, changing the saturation of a selected hue, and changing the brightness of a particular hue. And down here, these three graphs let us change the saturation of a specific range of light values. Increase or decrease saturation based on its current value, and adjust the saturations of specific colors. Let's go through these one by one. First, let's change one color to a different one. Select the eyedropper on the top right of the hue versus hue graph. Then in the inspector, click or drag over the color we'd like to change to a different color. Three control points will appear on the curve. The middle control point represents the color we selected, and the outer two control points limit the selection to a range of hues. We can drag the middle point up or down to change the color. And if we drag the other two control points, we'll adjust the colors outside of our range. Now let's set it back to the original values. With hue versus saturation, we can change the saturation of the selected color. We can drag the middle control point up to increase saturation or down to decrease saturation. And we can adjust the outer controls for the saturation of all colors outside the selected color. With this tool, we can make the selected color the only saturated one. We'll click on this reset button to return the saturation to the default settings. With Hue versus Luma, we can adjust the brightness of the selected color. Drag the middle point up or down to adjust the brightness. We'll demonstrate with another color. Or adjust the Luma of everything outside the selection.
Some people think this tutorial is a little humorous. See what I did there?
Next, let's check out Luma versus saturation. With this, we can adjust the saturation of a selected range of light or dark values. We'll select a midtone. If we move this control, we're controlling the saturation of the midtones only. And if we drag the outer controls, we're adjusting the saturation of the shadows or the highlights. Now for saturation versus saturation. Since these colors are pretty saturated, we'll decrease the value in a specific range. Drag this middle control up or down to adjust the saturations in that area. Dragging left of the curve will adjust the least saturated regions. And the right end of the curve will adjust only the most highly saturated regions. Finally, we can use this graph to change the saturation of any selected color. The default color is orange, which is useful for adjusting the saturation of skin tones. But we can select any color. The curve color and name will change to the color we selected. And notice the line that appeared. We'll click on the intersection and increase or decrease the saturation of the selected color. Be sure to add additional points if you want to narrow the range. Also, if we want to change the selected color in a different way, we can click on the color name and choose a new color from this wheel. So now we're adjusting just the mid-range and orange hues. You may have noticed that each of the graphs has a master control, which will adjust hue or saturation across the board, depending on which graph you use. Also, while adjusting a point, we can hold Option to make fine adjustments. This was a basic guide on how to use the Hue and Saturation tool. But if you'd like to learn more on how to color balance real footage, check out our tutorial linked in the description below.
So if you'd like to adjust your hue or saturation in Final Cut Pro, that's how you do it.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Like, share, subscribe. We'd love to hear what you think in the comments below.